Athletes and scientists typically refer to the concept of runner's high as a feeling of euphoria, well-being, and relaxation caused after a long period of aerobic exercise. In this video, we're going to explain what this high is, what happens inside your body when you get it, and the steps you need to follow if you want to feel it. The human being's survival instinct drives us to always look for things that make us feel good. So that is the reason why people take drugs, even though we, of course, know that drugs are not nice and bring a lot of problems. Then there are more activities famous for taking us to superior mental, spiritual, and mental states. But what happens if I tell you that you can reach that kind of superior sensation and well-being, like the ones you have after you use drugs, when you do physical activities, such as running? I mean, instead of taking substances, you take your tennis shoes and go outside and run. And then you can reach runner's high, or as we said starting this video, that feeling of euphoria and relaxation. Given how you feel afterwards, it's fair to summarize this feeling as getting high when you're running. For example, when you consume marijuana, there's a psychoactive substance inside it called THC. This is a chemical responsible for most of the high effects in the organism when you smoke weed. Well, with a runner's high, your body actually produces a chemical called endocannabinoids, and you can probably already guess where we're heading with this. These endocannabinoids produce a substance responsible for sensations like calmness, thus triggering the famous runner's high. It's true that endorphins are also the cause of pleasant and analgesic sensations felt during exercise and other activities that make people happy. For a while, it was thought that endorphins were the ones that triggered runner's high, but recent studies discovered that they are too big to enter the brain. It had to be something else. So that's how scientists ended up concluding the role of endocannabinoids in all of this. So one of the main differences between these chemicals is that the one that produces runner's high has a lot more interactions with the same brain receptors that interact with marijuana's THC. That is the reason why runner's high provides similar feelings as weed. But on the other hand, endorphins can't enter the brain, so they can produce sensations of well-being, which replicate some effects of morphine, for example. These effects are not related to those found on a runner's high. Some anthropological studies have shown why the brain began developing an effect like runner's high. They concluded that our ancestors' survival instinct depended a lot on chasing down food, and in order to do that, they had to travel long distances, and there was no better way to do that than running. For that reason, that activity played an essential role in their survival duties. When they ran long distances, they'd feel as though they were accomplishing their desire to live, getting more motivation, and then feeling sensations very similar to what we know today. Now, any runner who wants to reach a runner high has to know that it is only possible after a long run, sleeping well, and having a healthy lifestyle. It is almost impossible for a newbie to get a runner's high when they're just starting their training program. Also, keep in mind this experience is very different for everyone. The amount of endocannabinoids is never the same in two human bodies, and for this reason, the sensation felt during a runner's high can never be the same between two people. Sometimes you can reach it, and other times it just doesn't happen. There are a ton of variables that influence whether or not you'll get it. First, studies show that the routine needed to reach a runner's high is not about pushing your body to its limits. It's about making a challenging, but not extreme, workout. That workout can consist of at least 40 minutes or running at 70 to 80% of your average heart rate. But if you already have a running routine, try changing it up and pushing yourself a little bit more. If you run a mile in 10 minutes, try to run it in 9 and get a consistent pace during your routine. Try to run the last mile at the same time you ran the first one. Also, try changing your route. Of course, there are bigger chances of getting a runner's high if you run longer distances and if you run consistently. I mean, 3 times a week at least. Also, set your mind right and focus on running. Don't overthink reaching a runner's high and try not to worry about your speed and the time you want to get. Try to relax while you're running and get lost in your thoughts. Maybe use a music playlist or run with someone else if that helps. But remember that at one moment of the run, you will zone out. It is also essential to make intervals while you're running. So you need to avoid your body getting used to the same workout every time. The endocannabinoids need a moderated amount of stress in order to work. So it might be necessary to switch to some intervals of high intensity in your workout because during those intense intervals, your body will be having the stress required for the endocannabinoids to work. So After following these steps, you will know your body and your brain better, and you'll be able to find the specific elements of your training that make you feel the weightless sensation that people call runner's high. So, it is necessary to say that any cardio exercise can achieve it, like swimming, biking, or rowing. It doesn't come from running alone. What definitely applies to everyone is how tough it is to reach it and how hard it is to get it if you're a beginner or if you have little experience. There are testimonies of recovering addicts who run about their experience with runner's high, and they confess that this activity has been beneficial to handling their recovery process. Of course, during your training, you can feel very often significant sensations of well-being and freshness in your body, but oftentimes these sensations are not exactly runner's high. Most of the time, these sensations are related to the production of endorphins that, as we mentioned before, they're related to anti-stress and analgesic feelings. These are much more accessible and easier to reach than runner's high. Anyway, whether you're feeling it or not, exercising is always an excellent activity for your body. Also, soon, there'll be more research on the subject that will give us a better picture and more efficient ways to reach it. By the way, if you want to look at a funny visual representation of this concept, take a look at the second episode of the 13th season of Family Guy, called The Book of Joe, where Brian the dog experiences a runner's high while on a running date with a girl. We'll make sure we link the video in the description. So, last but not least, if you want to continue watching videos like this, we would greatly appreciate if you could share this video. This is the most useful thing that you can do to help us grow. And of course, please subscribe if you haven't done so. Thanks a lot for watching, and as always, stay fresh.